All right, now that I got a chance to sit still here, get some content up here, I want to take a quick break from politics for a minute here and get some laughs in. And, you know, I got to come back to body-worn camera footage, man. Some of this stuff, dude, is crazy. It's wild, man. And then some of it, I swear to God, I get a good, deep-hearted laugh out of. So here's one here that I just happened to run up on, and I had to watch it twice, and it still makes me laugh. You got to see this. If you haven't seen this already, you have got to see this, man. I'm telling you, it'll impress you, you know. But anyway, check this out.
On November 10th, 2023, officers responded to a call regarding a woman suspected of shoplifting.
Looking for her?
Yeah.
She just went to Zoomies. We're both law enforcement, too.
I don't know. 443, 10-4, check.
Well, I stopped moving out now.
Call 4, thank you. Copy. Come here. Don't buck. Over there.
Wow.
Come here.
Uh-oh, looks like...
Okay. Put it behind you. Behind. All right. Stop resisting. You got three of us here. All right. Good. All right.
Wait, put my key.
Yeah. All right. Hey, I'm taking this out of her hand because it keeps ringing.
Shouldn't have ran, huh?
Let
I need this one.
Let go.
My mom.
Nope. We're not doing that. All right. I will bend this back if we have to.
My mom.
Right, here we go. Hang on to that because I don't want her to. Okay.
What'd
she drop?
Me, oh,
I didn't see her drop. Oh,
I didn't see that. My mom,
I'm sorry if I laughed over that.
Absolutely.
There was a dude in the background that laughed, saw her hit that pole, man.
I didn't do nothing, man. I just was trying to contact and see if it was going old. I thought to use my shelf just now.
Did you?
Yes, sir.
Oh.
What's wrong with your mouth,
sir? That's what I'm saying. That's why I thought y'all was trying to complain to me for what I just did. And I just got the phone with him. And I told him that I didn't do anything.
Oh, man.
Sir, please, ma'am. Can you please answer for me? Sir, please.
What? We're going to have a long time to talk.
I don't want a long time to talk because I was trying to verify myself with the police. So that's why I thought when you were running after me, I thought that y'all was trying to blame me for what's going on. And I didn't do anything.
I got you.
That's what I'm saying. Can I please call the police, sir? Please, sir, please.
Hey, step down, watch your
hands. Let's get this off.
I don't mind getting it off. Can you please call her, please? I just brushed my mouth.
Yes, you did.
Like the,
yes, you did.
Spill you took.
Yeah.
All the way. This ain't gonna go very well.
You bust that grill hard.
Back up. Oh my God.
I appreciate your help.
Oh, man.
Anything?
Nope. You're
okay.
Good. Thank you. Yes.
I'm talking to you, sir.
I'm listening.
I just got off the phone with them. I called to verify it.
The guy at the phone with them at the college. He busted. Oh, God almighty, she bust that grill hard, man. She took out two of her teeth. You'll see it here in a sec.
Uh-huh.
What was going on? So I'm trying to figure out why was you running after me? That's why I didn't understand.
I didn't really run after you.
Huh?
I didn't really run after you.
You didn't? You said you was looking for me racially. That's what I'm trying to tell to you, sir.
Uh-huh. Hi, Kristen. This is Officer Khan with the Daytona Beach Police Department. Did you call about some girl from the Dunkin' Donuts? All right, we have a girl over here. I need someone to ID her. You're saying no one can come and identify her?
Somebody else is calling it in.
I appreciate
now.
It. Oh, no problem. No problem. That's what we do.
Wondering what kind of company policy is this.
Oh, more phone calls, Jemiah. More phone calls. That's the criminal justice system. It's all about more phone calls. So they don't want to come ID because it's store policy not to do IDs.
Okay.
I could take this girl for RA and then set the horse bowl with her or her loose. So RA it is.
She mm-hmm. ran. She got cut loose.
I have great news and less than great news. The good news is the business about the coach store is straightened out for now, and you're not in trouble for that.
It's bad news.
The bad news is you're going to jail for RA.
What's that?
It's what they call when the cops are trying to talk to you and they have a reason to contact you. You shouldn't have taken off running.
Understand what was going on.
So that possessed you to take off running if you didn't understand what was going on? What kind of sense is that? You really didn't understand what was going on. What was the reason to run?
Come on out of there.
This is Officer Forrest.
She is going to search you.
Okay, first of all, let me pause that right there. But like I said, I don't get it. I don't get it when people are. That's that excuse, you know, that, well, I didn't understand what's going on. You said this and it just, you know, just scared me and I just took off running. I'm like, well, what if you don't know what's going on, you don't understand a situation or something, then why would you take off running if a police officer is trying to talk to you, question you about something? If you're not guilty for something, then there's no reason to run. You're going to answer any questions he asks or anything else like that if you know you're not guilty of something. The only time you run, you know for a fact you're guilty of something when you take off running. Okay? That's just how it is. You know you're not guilty. There's no reason to run. They're not going to arrest you for something that you are not guilty of. There's no reason to run. People run when they know you know damn good and well you're guilty. Okay? That's not hard. We all know this.
What? They had me running from him, and I didn't even do what they said that I did. That's what's so
crazy. Can you turn around for this car for me?
Man, she smoked that pill hard.
Please. In the car for me, please. My hands. Wait, come see me.
She runs into a metal pole.
She did.
Blows out her tooth.
Yes.
And knocks herself out just for like a second or two. And had she just stopped and talked to me, the girl didn't want to come do an ID, so she would have been cut loose. So there's no IDs at the coach store. If you've got a girl over here or a guy, hey, come look, ID this guy. Uh-uh. Nope. Corporate policy.
So now you got just resisting arrest?
Not just a little, a VOP, a felony.
Oh, yeah.
She doesn't like that.
Hello. Who's filing a complaint? How can I help you?
Yesterday, my cousin was at work. She on the phone, but she can't talk like that. She can't really mess up, and her name is messed up.
Okay, so
she can explain to you exactly what happened.
He approached me. He parked over here by Under Armour. He approached me and said that I was being detained. And I asked him why was I being detained, and he was telling me that it was because of ongoing investigation. So I told him I already had called to verify myself. So I told him I don't have to speak to you. I walked out. So as the meeting of himself walking, but I walked out really fast. He was coming behind me. But I had him, me not fast, me trying to pass to him and me walking. I also hit a pole. Well, instead of me hitting the pole, I tripped and fell. And when I fell, he slammed me on the ground and detained me. But when he slammed me, I stepped in, but my whole mouth opened in. Two front teeth came out of my mouth.
Straight lie.
Okay.
Straight lie.
You can look through the pictures.
Hold up. Y'all heard that. He said he slammed me, and two of my teeth came out. Straight lie. She ain't gonna say nothing about the fact she ran into a pole at almost full sprint, about as fast as she could run. Wasn't paying attention, turned around, man, and smoked it. Smoked that pole. So, but come right here and just flat out lie I think she's gonna lie her way out of something. That victimhood mentality, man. Lord knows I'm tired of it. I'm tired of it. It's so annoying.
Well, fill out that.
Fill out this.
Yeah, okay. If that's what you're going to file a formal complaint.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll give it to his day shift lieutenant because I'm the night shift lieutenant. And then either they'll call you or someone from internal affairs will call you.
Okay.
All right?
Okay. I'll finish filling it out.
Okay. Okay. So I went in the back to look at the apps on cameras because we all wear body cameras.
And set the record
so it
straight.
Looks like when he got to the Dunkin' Donuts, she had left. So as he was walking around the outlet, there were some customers. There was actually some off-duty police officers. No, they don't work for us, just random off-duty. It was like, are you looking for somebody? And he said, yes. They told him what store she went in. She was hiding behind a display.
Mm-hmm.
So he came from behind the display. He was like, hey, don't run. Where are you going? You know, don't run. She takes off running. When she takes off running, she's looking back at him, and she runs into a pole. That's what knocked her teeth out.
Yep.
And then she runs into the pole. She falls. She gets up. She grabs her phone, and that's when he handcuffs her. So he never throws her to the ground.
Did he snap her or anything?
No. When she actually got up. When she hit the pole, she got up. And then that's when he grabbed her and just handcuffed her standing. He never put her back on the ground.
All on body worn camera.
Okay? All right. You're welcome. Have a nice night. Thank you.
Oh, man. Hey. Man, like I said, this is crazy. Crazy. That victimhood mentality crept on, man, just absolutely pisses me off, man. Everybody wants to be a victim for some odd reason. I remember growing up, that was the worst thing that you ever wanted to be, was a victim of something. You know what I mean? But I swear to God, now it's championed by people. I mean, they just look for victimhood rewards. I don't get it. I don't understand it. Make sure you turn into a victim for something. It's for something. Somebody had pity for you for something like that. Oh, it's not your fault. You know, yeah, I know you trying to stop. God almighty, man. Stop the victimhood crap and just be accountable. That's how I was raised. That's how I am to this day. Be accountable for your own actions. This victimhood mentality, man, is just, it's sickening. It's sickening. But I would honestly say this started from that participation trophy crap that started over 30 years ago. 35 years ago, whatever. This is what it's metastasized into, to this crap. It's into this now. I swear to God, it seems like all these kids, man, and even some adults, seriously, they just have this entitlement mentality. Don't be accountable for any of your actions. It's not your fault. It's always somebody and something else's fault. Always. Never ever hold yourself accountable. Pass the buck. When nobody held a gun in your head and made you do it. You chose to do it. Okay. And I say this all the time. Make choices. There are choices in life. You either choose to do or you choose not to do. Simple as that. It's not hard. Pretty damn easy. Make a choice. You either choose to do it or you choose not to. I teach my kids the same thing. You either choose to do something, or you choose not to do something. If you choose to do something, then this may happen. There might be consequences to your choice. If you choose not to, there's consequences to your choice for not doing something. Pick out which one works best for you to keep your nose clean, okay? It's not hard. But she paid the price. She paid the price big time. I can't believe she smoked that pole like that. Good Lord, man. But, you know, hey, in words of my man Chris Tucker from Friday would say,
you got knocked the fuck out.
Guys, let me know what you think in the comments below. Like I said, I had to break off and do this real quick because I can sit here and just rag on politicians all damn day. You know, it doesn't matter. You know, you guys know I'm a Gen X conservative, so I can easily, just as easily as I can call out the left, I can just as easily call out the right. Trust me, there is a lot of right rhinos, rhinos in the Republican Party that I absolutely can't stand. I can't stand them. Believe me, I am going to be doing some videos calling these clowns out as well. So anyway, let me know. Don't forget to leave, you know, the like, comment, subscribe, guys. Let me know what you think about this, man. If you got a kick out of this and watch that, I did. I thought it was funny. Maybe you guys like it or not. But anyway, I'll see you on the next one.